I think a lot of the support that industry got, they didn't spend it on their people.
Open this up. I could have gone on for another hour. It's wonderful to hear someone speak out their mind, you know, with all its complexities. But I'm going to open this up to the audience. And before that, I'd like to invite Marut Setia, who's the Senior Vice President at Indegene. And as I mentioned, you know, they're a global healthcare solutions. They look at digital solutions for healthcare. And Marut, you wanted to pose a question to Kiran.
Sure. So Kiran, I loved your thought process on why clinical trials need to take as long as they do. But if you start thinking about digital, and you spoke a lot about it, do you think digital interventions like, for example, digital CRO or reaching out to the healthcare professional digitally, would that help in making these trials faster? And how about using these in your own Biocon?
No, I think digital technologies are certainly the way of shortening many, many regulatory processes. Don't get me wrong. You know, one of the things that digital technologies and, you know, these kind of digital platforms allow you to do is to do a lot of parallel processing. So you can very sharply bring down the times. I think I fully subscribe to shortening the times. But there are some things which you can't shorten. For instance, you know, no matter how much predictive algorithms and biologies you can come up with, you still cannot extrapolate certain kinds of biological data to predict that this is how much it will protect you for. You know, those kind of algorithms are yet to develop. So you do need to validate those kind of prediction models in time. So I'm saying this is a time when you're trying to develop a vaccine for a very difficult virus. And the question mark is that if you were to get a vaccine in the next 2 months, would you be really would you really think it's safe enough? Is the question. So I think you need to validate it digitally all the time and keep doing post-hoc analysis and do predictive analysis to say, okay, based on this, I think it will protect you for X number of months and see whether it works out. And if it works out, you can use it for the next vaccine.
Right. So, no, absolutely. I think there are a lot of analysis that is happening on how you can narrow down the trial using digital analytics to a point where the chances of success are much higher. So,
Of course you can do it. You have to know what you're measuring. And today it's not just an immune response, is what I'm saying. There are many things beyond an immune response.
Absolutely. Makes sense.
See whether that immune response is a hyper response. If so, then is it doing something else? You know, this is what we learned about the virus, right?
Right.
You know, Marut, in fact, Kiran, you were really focusing on the digital end of it. You know, when I asked you how can health sector become the new IT sector in India, Marut, you guys have been involved in this a lot. Just very quickly, if you're looking at the digital shift post-COVID, what has COVID shown us? Does India have the building blocks in place or is there a huge gap? You know, are we very inadequate to make that digital shift?
Yeah. So India is in a very unique situation, if you ask me. I mean, the intent is very, very high, but the digital maturity is a little low. And it is not for lack of trying. I think it takes a lot when you're thinking about implementing a digital thread in the healthcare industry. You really have to have that combination of clinical expertise and the right technology, which finding in-house in an organization, in a pharma organization, is relatively tough. So by last 4 or 5 years, we are seeing some sense of urgency in terms of implementing a digital thread. The focus area still has been more on efficiencies. How can I reduce cost? But with this COVID, I really feel that people have started completely rethinking on how the business model needs to change. So this high touch model of a pharma rep going to a doctor or a medical device consultant going into a hospital, all those being are fundamentally challenged. And that is where I feel organizations are taking a much more holistic view of how do you use data, how do you integrate with the digital threat and use that power of analytics to make smarter decisions. And I guess this is where I think a company like Indegene comes in with 2 decades of experience and having implemented these digital transformations across mature markets and emerging markets. I think with 50 patents, significant investment in AI and machine learning, those are the ingredients that we are missing today in India, which will lead to a successful transformation. I just hope that COVID accelerates it much faster.
Well, you know, Marut, we've just recently announced a partnership with a company called Voluntis, yep, with whom we've developed a digital therapeutics for insulin. They were an FDA-approved product, a digital therapeutic product. And we believe that these are the kind of things that are going to happen in the future. And you're right. I mean, it's not just about, everyone talks about digital automation for efficiency, but it should be more from a precision and prediction modeling, which we really need to look at. And we need to sort of basically become more efficient through prediction modeling, and rather than just looking at doing things in a very, I always tell people, see, digitization is not just about transferring your knowledge from books to the computer. That's not digitization. Mm. Digitization is about how do you basically have a step up in what you're doing, because now you can do things digitally which you couldn't do in the physical world.
Lovely. And Kiran, I mean, just picking on that thread, as you know, and especially organizations like yours, which are new innovative drugs, as they move more towards precision medicine, personalization, personalized medicine, this whole idea of using the data and the data analytics power to create a very targeted approach or very targeted therapy, I think those ideas are really catching up.
Oh, today, let me be very honest. I mean, all the research we do is very targeted. I mean, today you have to understand pathways and mechanism of action in a very deep way. I mean, that's why I was talking about itolizumab, because we know the mechanism of action. It is very targeted therapy. It is not about just sort of, you know, looking at a possible way of working. You know exactly what it's doing. But, you know, biology is also very complex. So you will have off-target effects, which you must prevent. So that's, I think, your analytics comes in. How do you prevent off-target effects? And that's what you need to do for vaccines as well.
Yeah, no, absolutely. In fact, and my last comment, Shoma, I know you are raring to stop me, but So I think we have worked with a lot of pharma companies and where we implement called Intelligent Action Brain, which is where you get data from across the board, different processes that you have. And then, you know, organizations are creating a digital strategy office just to analyze that data and improve the efficacy of your product, not just in terms of the way you develop it, but the way you market it, the way you reach the patient, and all the way to how you manage and track adherence. At the end of the day, all of this has to come together to make a successful patient impact. And unless that is done, so I mean, listen, we would love to talk to you more about it. So I'm sure we'll get a chance to do that. Thanks a lot for your time.
It's fascinating.